It's week 10 of the DDPY Positively Unstoppable Challenge, and I am unstoppable. Welcome back to my channel. I am unstoppable. It's week 10 of the DDPY Positively Unstoppable Challenge. 10 down, 6 to go. On this week's episode, I wanted to talk about my results currently at week 10 and some of the momentum that I've been building into this week and kind of review some of my progress. And the main reason why I'm at the point where I am today is because of solid goal setting techniques and being able to follow up on all of those goals. So one of the topics of today's video I wanted to talk about is even beyond goal setting is techniques of visualization and the idea of being able to manifest your dreams into reality. So if you haven't already done so, be sure to leave a comment in the comment box below. How are you doing with achieving your goals at week 10 at this contest? So week 10 has been a huge milestone week for me. I did hit my specific weight goal of 225 pounds this week. So that was my goal of where I wanted to be at the end of the contest. So I'm actually 6 weeks earlier, and I've seen a huge difference in my physique over the last week or so. Before, where my clothes were fitting a little bit baggy, they're actually really, really, really kind of hanging on me. My pants, I'm at my last belt loop. They're physically falling off if I don't keep them up. So I'm at a point now of leanness where I needed to be at the end of this contest. So I had to make the decision, you know, where do I go from here? Just keep plugging away. I'm going to continue doing exactly what I'm doing here, continuing to improve every single week. Some of the small injuries that I was feeling last week, I'm not having any sort of problems with my elbows, my wrist right now. Everything is going really well. So this gives me an opportunity to go full speed ahead and kind of blow past where I thought I would be at the end of this contest. Another kind of milestone for this week as well was at the end of week 8, I hit my second 100,000 points on the app. So this week I actually received my new shirt. So I had the old version of the shirt, of the 100,000 point club shirt. So now I have the newer version. So I was super excited about that. So this is just giving me so much momentum going into next week and the week following after, where, I still have some improvements I can make on my physique. Of course, there's always something you can do better, but I'm really, really pleased with my progress right now. And I know that, I can blow past where I thought I would be. So I'm way ahead of the game. And the best part is mentally, I'm right where I need to be. I'm in it to win it. As I've always been saying this entire video and all the series is, I have a contest to win. And this is becoming more and more of a reality every single day. And I'm going to talk to you about why it's becoming more and more of a reality through my visualization techniques as well. So one of the main reasons why I'm in the position that I am right now is because of goal setting. Now, I've been a goal setter my entire life, and I attribute almost all of my success into the idea that I've always been a very, very strong goal setter. I set short-term goals, mid-term goals, and very, very long-term goals. And I've been very, very good at writing those down. I've been doing this for years. If you're new to this, one of the best ways to do this is Diamond Dallas Page's SMACDOWN acronym that he uses for goal setting. So SMACDOWN, SMACKDOWN. It's an acronym. S means specific. So let's talk about weight loss. Let's say at the beginning of this contest, I wanted to lose 15 pounds of body fat. That's a very specific goal. It's not, I just want to lose some weight or I have certain things to do. It's a very specific 15 pounds of weight. So you can apply that to any goal. M stands for measurable. So is that goal, how do you measure whether or not you're achieving that goal or not? So obviously with fat loss and weight loss, we use our scale. We use our tools that we talked about in previous videos, our measuring tape. We use in-body body scanning. We use body fat measurements. All of those things will let us know, are we getting closer or further away to our goal? Now, A is very important, and that's achievable. Is that goal achievable in the time period that you're setting? So if I say that I want to lose 15 pounds in, let's say, 2 months, is it achievable to lose that amount of weight that quickly? And in that type of goal, it's very, very achievable. That gets you down to about 2 pounds per week. So most would agree that that's an achievable goal. Now, saying that I want to lose 100 pounds in a week to go on vacation, that's not an achievable goal. So we have to be realistic about our goal setting. And also, if we're not being realistic, it's very, very important that we're probably not going to hit that goal. And then we actually might get down on ourselves. So set ourselves up for wins, not setting ourselves up for failures. Now, C is really, really cool. What C stands for is compatibility. So is my lifestyle compatible to reaching that goal? So let's again talk about that 15 pounds of fat loss goal. What are we doing in our lives that's going to get us closer to that goal? And what are the things that we're doing in our lives that are getting us further away from our goal? So if we're coming home every single night, picking up fast food on the way home, and just sitting on the couch and watching the next Game of Thrones and television and not really doing any physical activity, we're not going to lose that weight. So what we need to do is start cleaning up our diet. We have to start working out. We have to start possibly doing DDPY, which I think is a great way of losing fat. So we have to make sure that things that we're doing in our everyday life is compatible to achieving those goals. Now, K means keep it going. So once we get started, there's no turning back. Every single day we should be moving towards that goal. Now, the rest of the acronym D means do it. O means own it. N-O-W means write it down. And I think that's very important. I think it's, as DDP always says, don't just think it, ink it. I think writing down your goals is probably the best way to keep track of things. And N stands for now. So if you're not already using the SmackDown system of goal setting, try it out. Try it on a few small goals, try it on a few mid-sized goals, and then set some really, really big goals. And in just a minute, I'm going to talk about kind of manifesting your dreams into reality, big time goals that you can do with the power of your mind. Now, anytime I talk to people about visualization and manifesting things into reality, particularly large dreams of yours, sometimes I lose people. And what I'm talking about here is not the secret. I'm not talking about thinking about a Ferrari, hanging a picture of a Ferrari on your wall, and then magically a Ferrari just kind of shows up in your driveway. That's not the bullshit that I'm talking about. What I'm talking about is using visualization and manifestation as an advanced technique of achieving your goals. So as an example, behind me in all of my videos, I have my vision board. So my vision board is a series of photographs. I'm going to put a picture of that up on the screen now. It's photographic representation of my short-term, mid-term, and long-term goals. Now, what I do is I utilize this by looking at these photographs every single day. So what does this do? My subconscious is flooded on a daily basis with these images, and it reminds me of what my goals are. And it reminds me that these goals are achievable, and it reminds me what I truly want in my life. Now, sometimes our subconscious can turn to a different point where we're focusing on the negative things in our lives. We're focusing on the things that we don't want in our lives. And many would agree that if we're constantly focusing on the things we don't want in our lives, we'll see those things more often. If we're having negative self-talk in our brain, we're going to start to believe those things. On the opposite, I want to use my subconscious in a really, really positive way. The example that I give a lot to a lot of people when I talk about this is sometimes you'll go out and you'll see, let's say, a car, or you'll see an outfit that you like or a piece of clothing, and you see that and you're like, okay, I would really, really like to get that. All day long, when you're walking around and you're driving around, you may see that car on the road 10 or 15 times where your brain never would have recognized that car even existed. Or you may be walking around in the mall and you'll see 10 other people wearing that same outfit that you just thought, oh, wow, I really want. It's just our subconscious is open to seeing these things. So by using vision boards and by really, really visualizing the things that you want in life, we're opening up our brain in a different way to remind ourselves that these things are out there and these things are achievable and these things are very important to us. So on my vision board, what are some things that I include? I include people that I look up to as role models. So I have pictures of people like Tony Robbins and The Rock. That reminds me of strength. That reminds me of confidence. That reminds me of things like that. I always have things regarding maybe specific vacations I want to take. I've always had a picture of Greece on there. I really want to go there someday. So it reminds me every single day that that's important to me, that some point in my life, I go to Greece. I have a picture of me on top of a mountain, or I've always wanted to climb a mountain and kind of see the view from the top. I have just very, very specific. Recently, I had a beach house on my vision board to remind me that's one of the things that I want, is I always wanted to live near the beach. Well, within the last few months, I've moved into a beach house. I'm currently living in Carolina Beach, North Carolina. I'm 2 blocks off of the ocean. That was very important to me, and that was a goal that I've always wanted to achieve. So I put on my vision board things, how I want to feel, how I want to portray myself, specific goals that I want to hit in my life, and just the things that are constantly, I want to flood my mind with the importance of these feelings. Now, what I wanted to also talk about now is, you know, the idea of manifesting these things into reality. So from this point, it's really important to know exactly what you want in your life. It's important to know exactly how you have to get there. And one of the other advanced techniques I use is kind of manifestation. I use my vision board. I look at things. I imagine, you know, myself in these situations. If there's that, let's say, you know, specific vacation, I imagine what it's going to feel like to be there. I imagine, you know, the joy that I'm going to feel when I finally achieve that goal. But I also think about, you know, I have to work maybe a little extra hard to save up the money to get on that vacation. I have to take steps to get where I need to be. And I've been doing that every step of the way in this contest. I've been manifesting the idea of what is it going to feel like when I get that phone call? What is Dallas's voice going to sound like when he tells me that I'm the 2019 DDPY Positively Unstoppable Challenge Champion? I think about this every day. I think about the feelings that I'm going to feel, the joy, the celebration, the kind of relief of all the hard work. I think about these things day after day. I take a time in my day where I just think about, you know, the overwhelming feelings of pride that I'm going to have when I win this contest. And it's not an if. I have to really believe that I'm doing this. It's when. I've been thinking about, you know, the trip to the PC. I've been thinking about standing on that stage and having the cameras on me and having them announce me to the world that I'm have won this competition. I imagine what it's going to feel like to be on that stage, feeling, you know, the heat of the lights and the smell of the PC and, you know, just everything. So every single day I've been going through these exercises, and I really do truly feel that this is getting me closer and closer to my goal. Even if I don't achieve that goal, I'm flooding my brain with all of these positive thoughts instead of flooding my brain with negative self-doubts, thinking, well, did I do enough today to make sure that I'm gonna win this contest? I know that I'm doing enough. I'm not flooding my brain with ideas of, well, you know, there's so many other people in this contest, I probably won't win. I'm flooding my brain with the ideas that, no, I'm putting the work in, I'm doing everything possible to win this contest. I have a contest to win, and this is my destiny. So it's not, you know, overwhelming to my brain to think that this is a reality. And I truly feel by doing all the steps that I'm doing, it's getting me closer and closer to this goal every single day. Now, reality check time. If I don't win this contest, is it going to ruin my life? Absolutely not. But what are the great things that I'm getting out of this? I'm getting in the best shape of my life. Mentally, I'm stronger than I've ever been before. If this doesn't manifest itself into being a reality, I'm a much better person at the end of the day than I was if I wasn't doing all of this work. So that's kind of the main story that I wanted to tell you guys, is that if there's something in your life that you truly want, you can achieve it if you work hard enough and just constantly be working every single day towards those goals. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Again, if you can, make sure you leave a comment in the comment box below and like this video, and be sure to subscribe to my channel, I Am Unstoppable. So over the next week, I hope you guys do a great job. If you're not achieving your goals, if you're not working towards them, start today. Start writing them down. Start working really hard. So good luck with the rest of the contest, but remember,
beat me if you can. Outwork me if I let you.